Sustainable development. How do we measure it? Can sustainability be measured? How would you approach its measurement? And what principles should be considered? These are the questions that we'll be looking at in this video. There's a belief that if you can't measure something, you won't know whether you've attained it. Is it possible to measure sustainability? For those of you who are really serious about this subject, I recommend the book by Bellen Morris called Sustainability Indicators. Another excellent resource is The Natural Step. In this video, we present some fundamental ideas about measuring sustainability or measuring whether development is sustainable. The first comes from Herman Daly, a biologist. It derives from the principle that Earth is essentially a closed thermodynamic system and focuses on the use of natural resources. It also recognizes that all of society resides within this environment and thus is subject to all the implications of being in a closed thermodynamic system. One implication of being in a closed thermodynamic system is that all material resources that we use must be regenerated from within the system. Another is that all wastes must be absorbed by the system. Within the Daly rules for sustainability of natural resources, in order for the resources to be renewable, the rate at which they are consumed must be less than the rate at which they are regenerated. For non-renewable resources, such as radioactive uranium that is used for nuclear power, in order to reach a sustainable state, the rate at which the non-renewables are consumed must be less than the rate at which they are replaced by renewable substitutes. That is, looking at it from the other side, the rate of replacement by renewable substitutes has to be greater than the rate of consumption. And when considering pollutants, the rate at which they are emitted must be less than the rate at which they are detoxified and absorbed by natural systems. As you can see, these Daly rules for sustainability of natural resources focuses on the preservation of the physical world. Donella Meadows conceived of sustainability indicators as metrics to help monitor the progression toward the ultimate end, sufficiency of well-being for all. Her framework came from the Herman Daly triangle of humanity's purpose. However, we have represented it here as a flower. In her conception, the ultimate ends are harmony, community, enlightenment, and self-respect. Ultimately, these would be sufficiently abundant for all. The ultimate means, depicted here as the roots, would be raw materials, solar energy, the biosphere, and biochemical cycles. This constitutes our ultimate natural capital. In between the ultimate means and ultimate ends are intermediate means and ends. These are the social, human, and built capital that convert resources to the ultimate ends. The intermediate means are labor, tools, and infrastructure. The intermediate ends are knowledge, wealth, and mobility. Meadows suggested that in order to monitor progress towards sustainable development, we would need at least three types of indicators. One is an indicator for the sufficiency of real human well-being. For many years, the gross domestic product of nations has been considered a proxy indicator for well-being of a nation. The GDP includes the market value of all goods and services produced within a nation over a year. However, there is no distinction between the spending, for example, to engage in war, for mitigating crime or disaster. GDP measures the quantity that is spent, but it doesn't measure anything about the quality. In this way, GDP has been criticized as a false indicator of well-being. Other indicators have recently been advocated to better account for real progress. These alternative indicators could possibly serve as indicators of real human well-being. Meadows suggested that the second indicator be an indicator of environmental integrity or sustainability of the environment. The third indicator suggested by Meadows was one that measured the ratio of sufficiency of well-being to environmental integrity, which could serve as an indicator of the efficiency of conversion of resources to well-being. You can imagine that these measures are neither simple nor universal. This image reminds us of the need to include multiple perspectives in the development of sustainability indicators because of the unique viewpoint of people within a social system. In the end, an important question to ask is, why use indicators? Can we actually achieve these measures in a complex system? One philosophy is that indicators exist to enable a community to come together to dialogue about what they value and how to move toward their valued state. So the importance is that developing the indicators builds community that is then able to intervene in their own destiny in ways that are grounded in their shared values. There's no single method to measure sustainability. Sustainability indicators should be holistic in nature, measuring sufficiency of well-being for all, sustainability of natural resources, and efficiency of converting resources to universal well-being. When considering natural systems, the principle is to use them at slower rates than the regeneration rates. Complex systems require multiple viewpoints to adequately express the needs of all in the system. While indicators help monitor change, their value may be in how the process of developing them builds community. In the next video, we'll look at systemic resilience as sustainability.